convert the rectangular equation to a parametric form. So what would you do? We have to add t, so I can set t equals to whatever you have inside the parentheses. So x plus 2, then your y becomes 3 times t squared. So for the parametric form, you have to have an equation in terms of for x and y. So from the first equation, you'll go ahead and solve for x. So t equals to x plus 2, so move 2s to get t minus 2 equals to x. So I have x equals to t minus 2 and y equals to 3t squared. So here, when we convert the ellipse to parametric equation, you have plus, so I'm going to use the identity cosine squared of t plus sine squared of t equals to 1. So that means x minus 2 square over 9, this equals to cosine squared of t. And this, I can set that equal to y plus 3 over 4. And top you have square equals to sine squared of t, because cosine squared of t plus sine squared of t adds to 1 too. Then we can square root both sides to simplify. So I get x minus 2 over square root of 9 is 3, is cosine of t. And here when you square root both sides, you get y plus 3 over 2 equals sine of t. Then from here and from there, you can solve for x and y. So first move 3 by multiplying by 3. So I get x minus 2 equals to 3 cosine of t. And now I add 2. So I get my x equals to 3 cosine of t plus 2. And here, multiply by 2 on both sides to get rid of the denominator. Y plus 3 is 2 times sine of t. And then now you subtract 3 to solve for y. So it's 2 sine of t minus 3. So here's your parametric equation, x and y. Hyperbola. So here, when you convert the rectangular form to parametric form, it's something minus something equal to 1 and they're squared, so I can use secant square t minus tangent square t equals to 1. So I'll set this equal to secant square t. I'll set that equal to tangent square t. Now you're solving for x and y, so let's square root that first. So I get x over 4 equals to secant of t. Here when I square root the whole thing, I get y over 3 equals to tangent of t. So now you multiply by 4. So I get x equals to 4 secant of t. And here when I multiply by 3, I get y equals to 3 tangent of t.